Hello everyone, good to have your company on the last day of competition here at the Gabbro World Cup. Just one final and it's the men's trap competition. It has been an epic qualification already today. What was it, a 12 or 13 way shoot-off for two places in the semi-final. And in that qualification we did have an equal world record, and that from Jean-Pierre Brol of Guatemala, and the Turkish athlete Adnic Kabaci actually missed out on equaling it as well with the last shot of his 125 shots, which must be agonizing, I think it's probably fair to say. We've had a slight delay because of that shoot-off, and we are just about ready to go. And it's my pleasure to say hello to Eric de Velt of South Africa, who is here on your first World Cup event.
Yeah, thanks for having me, and it's been awesome, and look forward to the final.
Now, it's not for lack of success in South Africa, but you pick and choose where you want to go. You're here, you're Lenato, and I think the lure of Olympic qualification places has brought you travelling.
Yeah, I guess that's why most of the shooters are here, and I look forward to Lenato, and this has been awesome. And I'm hoping to shoot a lot more of these World Cups.
Well, we thank you for coming and talking to us. It's great to have your company. And there are the six lucky competitors. I say lucky, the skillful competitors who've outlasted everyone. It's been a long 2 days and a hot 2 days, hasn't it?
It's been very hot. The weather has been awesome. If anything, yeah, it's been a bit hot, especially on the middle range here, which hasn't got a roof, but perfect weather, perfect conditions, and you couldn't ask for anything more.
And you were saying that it's a little bit of a culture shock from winter in Cape Town, a bit cooler there at the moment.
Yeah, it's winter in Cape Town now. It's probably about 15 degrees or so, but this has been awesome.
Yeah, and it was an epic, I don't know if you saw any of it, but it was an epic shoot-off, wasn't it? 12-way shoot-off for two places.
I had a look there, I thought it would go a lot longer, but eventually they found two winners, and here we are in the semi-final. Good luck to the shooters who won it.
Yes, it was Hervé Bovin of France and Giovanni Cernogoratz of Croatia who prevailed. Three athletes went out with missing on the first target, which is a bit of a, after all that work, would be a bit disappointing.
Yeah, I was quite surprised when that happened, but I guess that shooting and the nerves catches up with you.
Absolutely. So let's have a chat about how this works. It's a semi-final of the six, of course, 15 shots, three series of five. Each athlete, of course, will take three clays from each of the five stations throughout the semi-final, and then the top two go into a gold medal match, the next two go into the bronze medal match. If there are any tight scores, and we say if, it probably will be, we'll have shoot-offs, and it can get a bit complicated if a lot of shooters say you have a five-way tie. We've had that this week as well. Well, we'll talk you through it, don't worry. Luckily we have Eric here just to guide us gently through those waters.
Yeah, it gets a bit complicated, but it's all part of the excitement, and I guess that's why we're all to enjoy it and look forward to it.
Yeah, you can see the man in the blue bib behind the shooters there. That's Albert Bratninov of Russia. I beg your pardon, that's Jan Reiber of the Czech Republic. He's the referee, and the other person who has to sort these things out is the jury member, and that is Albert Bratninov of Russia. And hopefully there won't be anything too complicated for them to sort out. Of course, last night we had the slight drama of Leonard Tkach being disqualified because of the weight of the cartridges, and that caused quite a delay and quite a lot of discussion amongst the officials.
Yeah, that was very unfortunate. She was using factory ammo, and unfortunately one of the cartridges was overweight, and she, according to the rules, had to be disqualified. So,
ladies and gentlemen, the organizing committee of the ISSF World Cup Gabbro 2015 and the International Shooting Sport Federation welcome you to the Gabbro Shooting Club here in Gabbro. The finals competition for the trap men's event will now begin. There are two Olympic quota places up for grabs in today's finals. If the highest scoring countries of this event have already received their maximum amount of quota places, those places would automatically go to the highest scoring countries below. So ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present to you the finalists. At position number one, representing Croatia, World Cup gold medalist in Beijing in 2011 and current Olympic champion Giovanni Comegoas.
Yes, the reigning Olympic champion only has one World Cup win, and that was 4 years ago.
At position number two, representing Turkey, making his first appearance in the final six of a World Cup, Ernik Kabachi.
Just 22 years of age, his best placing before this in a World Cup was 76th.
At position number three, representing Guatemala, making his first appearance in the final six of a World Cup and qualifying with an equal world record, Jean-Pierre Brault-Cordenas.
Just outside of the semi-final in Larnaca earlier this year, today he qualified first with a perfect and world record equaling 125
at
shots.
At position number four, representing France, also making his first appearance in the final six of a World Cup, Hervé Boivin.
Best place so far for the Frenchman in a World Cup, believe it or not, is 113th, so this will be a real experience.
At position number five, representing Italy, two times World Cup silver medalist and three times World Cup bronze medalist, Erminio Frasca.
The policeman from Priverno has yet to hit gold in the World Cup, although he's made an Olympic semi-final and has struck World Cup final gold.
At position number six, representing the Russian Federation, Olympic Games gold medalist in Athens, and he also took he's also 20 World Cup medals, Alexei Alipov.
Yes, the man from Moscow turned 40 this week. Will he celebrate with a seventh World Cup gold? So there we go. Those are our six athletes. And Eric, it has to be said, it's a really interesting mix of experience, a world Olympic champion, the current Olympic champion, and some for whom this is new territory.
Yeah, I'm sure a lot of athletes will be tested today, and good luck to them all. And I think experience counts a lot in these finals, and we'll see if it comes through today or if the thirst for their first finals, maybe that comes through. We'll have to see.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's an interesting sort of thing, isn't it? Whether perhaps just coming in fresh with no experience, a bit fearless, just give it a go and see what happens. You've got no expectations, it might be the best thing.
I reckon, yeah. This is an absolute mind game, these finals. It's the fact that you only have one shot changes everything, and the nerves is funny things, and works while you shoot, and I don't know.
We will see. We will see. Like you say, here is the Croatian. First away, and our first hit. Kabachi of Turkey. Just two athletes unable, already have the Olympic quota place, and that is Frasca of Italy, Alipov of Russia. Here's a man who certainly isn't used to these finals, and a first miss from his first shot.
Yeah, I think it's an inexperienced showing there, but maybe he'll keep it together for the rest of the semi-final.
You certainly want to be hitting your first shot, but a lot of people we've seen in other competitions throughout this week missed the first one and then carry on in important and impressive style. Just the one miss then in that first pass. Oh. It is still hot out here. What is it? Just 6:10 local time. Croatian doing well. Here's the man from Guatemala. And a miss for him. The brother, of course, of Enrique Brault, who won a silver in Larnaca and in the double trap. So a bit of sibling rivalry here, I'm sure. Frasca, so far so good for him. Now Alipov, so experienced, 40 years of age and one day. Happy birthday to you, Alexei. I hope you had a good party last night.
I doubt it, but maybe we'll postpone it till after this semi-final.
They say the volcano's good around here, but perhaps best, like you say, to wait until it doesn't make any difference to your shooting. Here is Brault.
Fortunately missed that one.
Yeah, that's Two out of two, just the one hit for the man from Guatemala. Ranked 21 in the world, but just not having the form at the moment.
Still early in the semi-final, it can change.
Absolutely, we shoot five, or they shoot five each. Then we have a little pause and reflect on the score. And then we go again. It can happen very quickly. And that's the one that was catching the women out yesterday, that low to the left. It's a tricky one.
It is a bit tricky, and it's fast and low, and if your reflexes isn't perfect and quick, then you're going to be behind that one.
On to our fourth pass of these athletes. And then, what can Brohl do here? That's better. He'll feel a whole lot better having sunk that one. If you can just keep going, you never quite know what might happen.
Yeah, it's funny the dynamics of these semi-finals. I mean, after missing, and if you got an attitude of coming from behind, and the guys in front are defending, and suddenly you find yourself right up there again. So
it's interesting, isn't it? Because we do talk, a lot of my co-commentators and I, we talk about the fact that it is. You talk about muscle memory, you talk about reflexes, and, you know, your good eyes and coordination, but a lot of it's in your head, isn't it?
Ah, absolutely. I think when you start out shooting, it's a lot about muscle and coordination and that sort of thing, and learning how to shoot. And once you get to this level, it's 99% of mind game.
Well, this guy's doing well, isn't he? 22 years of age, 76 his last, or his best, and he is perfect. The Turkish guy, the Frenchman, doing pretty well as well. Just the one miss from him. We are certainly moving ahead here. Arminio Frasca from Paderno, the policeman. He is, at the moment, perfect. Five out of five for him as well. Just the two athletes he misses. That's Brohl and Boivin.
So after those first five competition targets, as you can see,
so we have five targets down, and this is how it looks at the moment. Four-way tie for first. Boivin of France with four targets, and it hasn't gone that well for Jean-Pierre Brohl of Guatemala. But there's still 10 targets to go, and anything can happen.
Of Guatemala, but still, there is still obviously a longer way to go with today's semi-final. A lot can change from here. 10 targets remain.
So then, time for us to get underway, and it's Sino Graz of Croatia, one of those two athletes, the Frenchman, the other one who came through that 12-way shoot-off. Took 13 shots in the end. It was a bit congested on that far range, wasn't it? Almost as many people there watching the shoot-off as here watching the finals.
Yeah.
Oh, just a puff for the Turkish athlete. He got away with that one.
Guys, interestingly, if they use flash clothes, you don't need to see a chip, just a puff of smoke. It's fine, and then it counts as a kill.
Yeah, it's a bit of a godsend for television.
Yeah.
Don't always use them in other competitions for qualifying, but certainly helps us. And a little bit of a hindrance for the athletes in the double in the skeet, rather, because they were unable to see through the mist because it was so still the first couple of days up here. But there's a bit of breeze. Not too much to affect the targets. I don't know how it was in qualifying.
Yeah. It's Not affected the targets at all, I think. If anything, it just kept you cold a bit, and otherwise was a bit hot out there. So I think the breeze was welcome to most shooters.
The man from the Izmir Shooting Club, certainly on it at the moment. 7 out of 7 for him. Here's a man with a bit of catch-up to do. Man like his brother involved in the farming business back in Guatemala. Boivin. Soldier by trade, and just that first shot letting him down. Apart from that, he's looked very busy and very good. Frasca now of Italy. Certainly caught that one well, and here's the old man, 40 years and one day. Just want to put ear defenders on, can't hear me.
I think his experience is showing, he's hitting them very nicely.
Yeah, not even clipping them, hitting them full on. As our American friends would say, smashing them. Olympic gold medalist, the Russian, of course, and the bronze medalist. And just the six gold medals in the World Cup as well. Here's Brian, a man who's trailing everybody, but he's hitting the targets now.
Yeah, he's recovered nicely after those two misses, but like I said, it can all change in a blink of an eye.
Pashka, perfect so far. Can he keep the shuttle going? That was low and straight through. No problem for him. And these athletes, I guess, will now know, having gone through most of these stations and on the second series, that they'll know what's coming up next, probably, if they've kept their wits about them. Kapapchi. One of the more slight figures.
Is there a broken target?
Yep, no target. That's the first one we've had. Quite a few as the women's event progressed. I think it was the heat more than anything.
Ooh.
That looked like a little chip, but no. Or the flags go up and the hand of the referee. And that's the first one from Kabachi. I just wonder if the no target didn't help too much.
It tends to put a lot of shooters off if you get a no target. And looks like it got to him.
Yeah. That's the first miss in quite some time, that certainly in this series of five. In this semi-final, in the men's trap event here in Gabala, the last one of 15 events of this mixed World Cup final. There's another one, and I think that's from the same station. I think it might be, actually. It is. Well, keep your head down and keep yourself composed.
And he smashes that target, that's experience showing.
Yeah, wasn't at all worried, was he? Just sat there and waited his time.
Oh, another no target.
Well, now they're starting to pile up, aren't they? We're more than halfway through this semi-final. And that will cause a delay. It might well be that, I do remember having a chat to the referee, Vision. And I wonder if they might have a little check a bit later on. It's on that right-hand side that the problems are happening.
I remember today throughout qualification that on station 5 on this particular ranger we had a couple of no targets. So
that's obviously perhaps an issue just with one. There are several, I think it's 9 and in the trap just in front of these athletes. They check everything before a final, just how far they're going, the elevation. One thing you can't check is whether they're going to break before they get out. That's the tricky one, the low left, and it was nicely done by the Frenchman, Hervé Boivin. Now Frashka, look how well he's going as well.
Oh, he's also been looking very good in the semi-final. He smashed all the targets, as you say.
Alipov finishes his targets, and there are three athletes who are still yet to miss, and Chernograf, Frashka, and Alipov, 10 targets each. Bovan and Kabachi, well, we said about these athletes, if they kept hitting the targets, they have a chance of getting into the bronze medal match.
Position at the moment is Brol Cardenas. After these next five targets, we will be deciding which two athletes are eliminated and also which athletes will be going into our medal matches. Five targets remain.
So then, getting really to the sharp end of this competition. And, for the athletes, what you're trying to say to yourself is it's just another shot. Don't even think about the context of this. It's hard to, though, isn't it?
Yeah, I think that's where the good is. From the average is
Well, those who've just missed one have a chance, they really do, of getting into a medal match. At the moment, though, they may well be a shoot off to see who drops down from a gold medal match into the bronze medal match. Three-way tie at the top at the moment as we go through this 11th pass. Here's the Italian, one of those looking good. Alipov can hoiking himself up to 11 points. There you go, as you can see, that's how it looks after 11 shots out of 15. Away we go again. And if you're new to shooting, you'll see there's 5 stations, 6 athletes, and they all move across one after they've shot. A little bit different in the medal matches, of course, just the 3 stations. And they do still rotate, but they don't have to queue up behind anybody else. Certain etiquette to that, of course, isn't there, Eric?
Yeah, yeah. You are in the middle matches, so you shoot 2 shooters on the 3 stations, and you only move once both shooters have shot. And it's also quite a different dynamic from the semi-final again, and shooting one-on-one, and we'll see how that goes.
Yeah, again, if you're inexperienced, you've just got to be really concentrating just on the shot, because there's a lot going on. TV cameras out there, of course, as well. That's a tricky one, isn't it?
Another no target there.
Yeah. That time on our centre station.
Yeah, like you said, it's a tricky target, so maybe it's a blessing in disguise, a no target, and I know it's coming.
You know it's coming, yeah. Don't overthink it. That's what most of those athletes are. They sit next to say. Oh, and there's the miss.
That's just as you said, normally you overthink it and... If there's anything going through your mind except the clay target itself, then probably going to miss it.
Well, that's the Croatians' first miss, which means that, funnily enough, the 2 athletes who can't get the Olympic quota at the moment are on track for the gold medal match. That's Alipov and Fraška. Oh, we just have a miss there from Boivin. That's his second. There's Fraška. Keeps his impressive record going. And now the chance for the Russian as well, homing in on a gold medal match. He looks so cool, doesn't he?
Well, interestingly, if everything stays as is, we won't have a shoot-off for the first time in how long.
No, and this is your first time next week, but we have to have this discussion about commentators' curses. Kibachi, who could well find himself in a bronze medal match. Brawl, already missed 2. Hits that one. It's the 14th out of 15 for these athletes. Better from the Frenchman. Have to say it's a...
Oh,
there is the miss.
From the Italian.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, we just had to go and say it, didn't we?
Yeah.
First miss from Fraška. So it's Alipov, who at the moment is in the lead with an unbroken record. And then we have a 3-way second place. So Cernogratz, nicely done from him. He shoots 14. A lot of support for the... Turkish team here, of course, a lot of cultural links with Azerbaijan. So 14 for him. Brol hasn't perhaps been his day. Now Boivin, that might have been a costly miss right at the end. Croatian is busy celebrating in the background. Fraška, what could be an expensive miss right at the death there. He gets 14 out of 15, and can we have one perfect series here? Yes, we can. Excellently done by Alipov, who gets himself into the gold medal match. But the question is, who will join him? We have a 3-way shoot-off. Cernogratz, Kibachi and Fraška will decide who goes into the gold medal match, so, and who will have to settle for the bronze medal match.
Unfortunately, Brol there after shooting 125 out of 125, and it doesn't make the middle matches.
So here's how it's finished, and just a reminder that there are 2 who exit at this point, and it's a disappointment for Jean-Pierre Brault and Hervé Boivin. They have to make way, sit down and find some shade and watch the rest of it. But as you can see, we have a three-way shoot-off. The winner, the one who outlasts everybody else, will be in the gold medal match. And then the other two will then have to stay at the station and shoot the bronze medal match.
And I think we might add that the Turkish athlete and the Croatian, they are quite off places for the country, and that's why they're celebrating, and it seems like it's a bit early, but it's because of the quota places they already got, and but they still have to shoot for the medals.
So those the athletes who can just a few moments. Thank you. Take a rest. That Frenchman, his biceps are massive. Not necessarily a requirement in this sport, but it does help. So, a bit more time in the sunshine, and we will find out who it is who will prevail and go into the gold medal match. It's just such small margins that stand between success and failure in this sport.
Yeah, in these conditions the shooting is normally good, so it's always going to be small margins. And might add that the scores that was shot in this competition, I think there was about 15 odd guys and a 122 out of 25 that missed out on even the shoot-off, and normally that would get you at least in the shoot-off to a semi-final.
Yeah, it was a very high quality, wasn't it? 125, three guys on 124, including of course Kebapchi, who missed that last 125th shot he missed. I wonder if that was on his mind. Anyway, look, we have to concentrate on the shoot-off to see who goes into the gold medal match, who will go into the bronze medal match. Three athletes, all guaranteed a place in a medal match. The question is, which one will it be? Cernogorac of Croatia, the reigning Olympic champion. New dramas for him. And Kebapchi, who is 10 years younger than Cernogorac.
It will be interesting to see if the Croatian and the Turkish athletes can keep up their concentration here. After winning the quarter places, I see they were already celebrating and quite excited about that. And it's now to see if they can add the cherry on top.
Yep, Cernogorac and Kebapchi with the quarter places, because Brault and Boivin have already had to make way. So far, so good for all these athletes. We're talking about the muscles of Boivin, but you look at the Croatian, and in particular Kebapchi, really quite slight, in certainly in comparison to the majority of shotgun shooters, certainly the men.
Yeah, I don't think your build makes such a difference. Like I said, after learning how to shoot, and if you can shoot, it's 99% the mind game. So if you can keep it together up here, then you'll do good.
No target, little fragment flying away to the left. We mentioned that you look at his what he's done on the shooting CV. 76th in Beijing in 2011. Is best in a World Cup. Well, he's certainly done better here. Italian coach is out of his seat and gesticulating towards the jury member. Not sure what that was all about. He's still having a conversation. Well, his man Fraschke is just blocking everything out. Two targets hit per athlete. We go on with this shoot-off. Can you imagine? It may take a while before we sort out the positions here, and hopefully straight into a bronze medal match and then the gold medal match. 6:30 local time. Slightly cooler, but it's all a matter of degree.
Oh, and Turkish athlete misses.
It's that nasty one that goes away to the left.
Yeah.
The athletes have not liked that at all. So if Frashka hits here, they will continue.
And he does it.
So that means that the Turkish athlete will be in the bronze medal match. He's still having this conversation, the Italian coach. Have you got any idea? Because I certainly haven't, what he's angry about.
No idea. He's quite animated, but I don't
know
why.
In the Italian way, yep.
He was quite animated last night with the women's incident
we talked
about.
Yes.
And here's another no target. So his argument was, which I guess makes sense, that if the athlete was disqualified, she shouldn't have shot in the final, which changes the whole dynamics of the semi-final. And I guess he's got a point. So.
Well, some coaches you hardly get a twitch out of. And why not? You're battling for your athletes, aren't you? It's your right to do that.
And the Italians, I guess, they are very emotional.
Well, yes. Very expressive, shall we say.
And very good shooters, I might add.
Absolutely. They've done so well. Not just in the shotgun events, but they're also there or thereabouts in the final assault. In the small group. Oh, that was a wicked one. Went low and away to the right. And that means that Frashka will have to settle for the bronze medal match. And Cernogorac, the Croatian, will go into the gold medal match against Alexei Alepov.
Who's going to which medal match? Firstly, we will have a
sun, as you can see, setting on the last day of this World Cup. And we're almost at the end here.
And then we'll commence with the gold medal.
Frashka against Kapaci.
We will see Croatian Giovanni Sioglouras join Alexei Alepov in that gold medal.
That's
match.
How it also, has finished after the semi-final.
Cernogorac
into the gold medal
so
match alongside Alexei Alepov.
Please give him a big round
and
of applause.
Arminio Frashka and Erdinç Kebapci, they will contest the bronze medal match. Cernogorac and Kebapci, they are the athletes with the quota places for Rio, which is now just under a year ago to go. So then, bronze medal match is next. We will find out who will take the bronze in what has been a long day for these athletes. How many hours were you out qualifying, Eric?
Well, it started at 9 o'clock this morning and it's half past six now, so it's a long day out there in the sun, in the heat. And athletes just make sure they stay hydrated and keep the concentration up there. And looks like certainly Alepov has managed to do so, and Cernogorac, congratulations to them on making the gold medal match.
Well, absolutely. Came through the shoot-off as well. So it just goes to prove that if you get through the shoot-offs, you can get a gold medal. It doesn't mean just because you qualified, you just squeaked qualification.
So, ladies and gentlemen, firstly taking part in today's bronze medal match.
You're not going to make it to the top of the podium.
Erdinç Kebapci.
Kebapci then, a 22-year-old,
and also
cool as a cucumber.
Medal match today, representing Italy, Arminio Frashka. Let's begin the bronze medal match.
So then away we go. It will be the Turkish athlete who gets us underway first of all. From the İzmir Shooting Club. Two right-handers here, of course. Not seeing that many left-handers prosper this week. Both indoors or outdoors. As we said, best of 76th in the World Cup. If you look at his biography, well, he's certainly done better than that, but he will be aching for a medal. Reminder, back to 15 shots in five series of three. Just the centre three stations that we use for the shoot-off. And I guess, in a way, that makes a bit of a difference as well.
Yeah, they change it because you can get all five targets from each station, and still only because you don't have six shooters that needs to use all the stations, so you only need to use the middle three, and you can get all five targets from each station.
Yeah, getting the getting all the targets, of course, but like you say, not so far to walk for these two athletes, keeping it compact. How are we going to finish this first series of three shots? Nicely is the answer for Erdinç Kebapci. What can Erminio Frasca do? The man from Priverno. 10 years older than his opponent.
So after those first three,
but you wouldn't know. 3 and 3 for these athletes.
And Frasca both tied now at this early stage with a total of 3 targets each. 12 targets remain.
Well, the Turkish coach is looking cool. I like the shades. And he'll be very proud of what Gabapci has managed here. And there's a large contingent, a lot of the Azerbaijani crowd here will want the Turkish athlete to do well. Historically good links.
Oh, another no target for the Italian.
Our Italian coach looking a bit calmer now. Frasca, one of those athletes that didn't need to come through that massive shoot-off. Just the top four, you had to shoot 124 to be sure of qualifying. That's astonishingly good. The standard from these athletes. Just very difficult to get up with them, isn't it?
Yeah, both shooters looking very focused and confident in their first few shots of this medal match. Oh. And I guess there's the commentator's curse.
You're getting good at this one. Well, it is Frasca of Italy, and if you can lip read Italian, you can tell that the Italian coach was none too pleased. Just a slight advantage. There's still a long way to go here, of course. Count your chickens, and you won't be either.
So after
six targets then, and Frasca with a bit of work to do. His coach not quite as calm as he was a few minutes ago.
So it is Capacci that finds himself in first position, but only one target separate the two athletes at this time. 9 targets remain.
Still a long way to go, as you can hear, in this bronze medal match. Does he have the experience just to keep going? This Turkish athlete, saying he's a slightly frail frame, compared to some athletes, but certainly not mentally, and his ability is up there with everybody's.
Yeah, he's been hitting them very nicely.
And if he can just keep going, he knows in his mind, as the VIPs, they get the best seats. We managed to find some nice ones for the commentary position. They're watching as well, and we've really enjoyed very good support. Full houses. Oh, there's another no target. Seems to just have a few more as we go on in the competition. You kind of suspect it's just the conditions, and that was low and fast and nasty, and he did very well. So shotguns, real works of art in themselves, really. Not cheap.
No, most definitely not, especially the Italian shotguns that most shooters use. And I guess they do the job very well, so that's the reason they're expensive.
Of course, if you're interested in getting involved in shooting, there's a miss. And that's one.
All tied up again.
Yeah, a miss apiece. I'm just going to say, if you're interested in getting involved in shooting, contact your local shooting club. I'm sure you won't have to lay out a lot of money on a shotgun. We'll let you have a go and see how you enjoy it.
As you can see, Capacci 8, Frasca 8.
8 apiece.
Both athletes tied. Capacci dropping one target in that last round.
Very tight, isn't it?
So as you can see, it is 9
out of 15 targets shot.
Final 6 targets.
6 more targets to go, as our announcer Daniel Potts so rightly points out. Keeping the crowd informed of what's going on here. Not far to go.
Could we go well after that miss?
Yeah, because he's just got to think, well, it's still level. Let's not worry about it. That one shot away to the left, but it was well covered by Frasca. Ooh, is that a miss? It is.
Yeah, he also got that tricky one.
Yeah, he knew it was going away to his left, and there's a miss. And there's an opportunity for Frashka, who's been behind, as you can see, for a lot. Oh, and a missed a broken target, a no target. He's been behind for most of this match, and all of a sudden has the advantage.
No, it's a funny thing, these medal matches can all change in the wink of an eye. And it does.
Yeah, don't take your eyes off these targets, because something might just happen.
Oh!
Well, just the 1 point though, four targets each to go. Let's not decide who's going to get this bronze medal just yet.
Most definitely not.
Oh.
Straight through, and nicely done. Well, he's certainly got a great temperament, doesn't he? Just turns away, takes some sweat off his brow, not looking at this.
Oh.
So after 12 targets, 12 now targets gone. Jumped into the lead.
Three still to go. 11-10 the score. Turkey and Kabachi just behind the Italian Frashka. And now three more shots to see whether it will be an Italian, another medal for the Italians in this World Cup, or whether Turkey can take it perhaps to a shoot-off or even more. Well, took his time there, but certainly hit it well.
Oh.
That wasn't quite so convincing, but it's a hit, and as any shooter would tell you, a hit's a hit. Less and less opportunity now to pull this back. Just got to keep going, Kabachi, and hope for the best from Frashka. Oh, and that will be that. Oh, dearie, mate.
So if the Italian hits any one of these last targets, he gets the bronze medal.
And, well, you wouldn't put your mortgage on it, but you'd be hard-pressed for him not to do it. Yep, so it is his. I'll wait till the last two are blasted before the celebration start. Kabachi, though, great effort from the youngster. And I think we'll see more from him in the future.
Oh.
Nice way to finish. Just the three misses. He was shooting so well up to the last few shots. And this one, academic, but it won't be to Frashka. He will want to hit it, and he doesn't. Well, how often do you find that? But it doesn't matter. So little smile from Frashka. He will take the bronze, and Kabachi will have to settle for fourth. What an interesting semi-final bronze medal match that was.
Country, Ernik Kabachi.
Well, a lot of the Azerbaijan locals here would have liked a bronze for the Turkish athlete, but a very good effort from Kabachi, the 22-year-old, taking fourth. And Frashka, the man from Priverno, taking the bronze medal. That's his, what is it, his fourth bronze medal. He has two silvers, three bronzes, but as of yet not a gold.
No, very unfortunate for the Turkish athlete. He shot very, very well throughout qualification, and to miss out in the medals, but at least he got his quota place for the Olympics, and I think that's
as important.
What he wanted.
Well, here's how it looks for the gold medal match. Senor Garach taking on, of course, the old stager Alexei Alipov, who celebrated his birthday yesterday. So I hope he had a nice time. And a gold medal will be what he wants for his birthday, I imagine.
A gold medal, I guess.
Yeah. Silver won't be too shabby either. So then we await these athletes. They're down already, as you can see. Senor Garach, 32 years of age. He's a waiter by his day job. And that's an unusual profession. Very often see soldiers, policemen, people who can perhaps more easily get time off. I know, obviously, you're a businessman, Eric, and you can give yourself some time off.
So, ladies and gentlemen, firstly taking part in today's gold medal match, representing Croatia, Giovanni Konogolas.
Just the one World Cup gold in Beijing 4 years ago.
Representing the Russian Federation, Alexei Alipov.
Well, both these guys have gold medals at the Olympic Games. Semenkhodach in London, so he's the reigning champion, of course. And Alipov in Athens way back, makes me feel old, in Athens in 2004, 11 years ago now.
Can't believe it.
And the bronze in Beijing as well. But just that one gold in the World Cup final, fared slightly better in the World Cup, six. But the last gold medal for him was 5 years ago in the World Cup, so perhaps it's overdue.
Yeah, I think he would want to change all that and make sure he gets another gold here today.
Wind up, 15 shots as the semi-final, but shot over three stations, so five series of three. Good start from both these athletes.
Croatian gets that tricky left-hander and hits it nicely.
It's partly the fact it goes away to your left, it's partly the fact it is so low, isn't it?
Low and fast, yeah.
World ranked 34, Semenkhodach, 17 in the world, Alexei Alipov. Here is the Croatian, two shots out of two, neck and neck these two. Straight down the middle, that's a nicer one to have. And the elevation helps as well.
So after those first three targets,
three targets down,
both
three targets hit.
Neck and neck. Great shooting there early on by both our athletes with a total of three targets out of three. So we now move on. 12 targets remain.
A referee, Jan Leiber. It's the Croat to get to this station.
It was a target thrown without the referee seeing it.
Yeah, we saw it go.
It was a no target, but the Croatian got it nicely now.
Alipov, look at the concentration. There's that tricky one away to the left.
Yeah, I was saying that one is fast, but they're all actually fast, roughly the same speed. It's actually the angle that it goes out. It looks like a 45 degree left-hander. That's why it's so difficult. And like you said, the fact that it's very low.
Yes, they will be testing half an hour before this final, making sure they're coming out of the traps well. And they have to go over a line, a certain distance.
Yeah, they are all supposed to go 76 meters.
There's yellow pollards out there, which indicate that. Semenkhodach with bib number one. Will he be first amongst equals here? Just got a nibble of that one. It wasn't particularly convincing.
It's it.
There's the shooter's mantra.
So after six targets, it stays the same. Konogolas and Alipov both tied in first position at the moment. Both tied with a total of six targets. And nine targets remain in today's gold medal match.
So getting through these targets in quick start, as you can see, six plays six, nine targets left. Miss early on is not great, a miss late on can be terminal.
Alipov smashes that one.
He looks very comfortable in his zone. Much shorter than this guy here, the Croatian athlete. Giving away about 8 centimetres. Makes no difference, really, as long as you've got the ability. Stephen Scott, we saw earlier in the week, very short guy who got the silver, of course, for Great Britain.
Yeah, in the double trap. Shot really well. And he also got quite a place for his country, yeah.
Smiles all around. Couldn't quite go on to get the gold.
Oh, miss from the Croatian.
Well, our first miss. red lit up against the green of the scoreboard away on our right hand side. Red against white, so as you can see on our television screens. So then, it is Alipov looking good for that gold medal, but there's still a few targets to go. Another six targets to go.
Six targets remain.
We saw in the bronze medal match how it can all change around. So let's not count our chickens just yet. Suljana Gracz. Nicely done. Good recovery.
Yeah.
Not good when you miss and then have to sit out and you hear the announcer describing the miss.
Yeah, that's just pull yourself together and go on and make sure you keep the pressure on. It's only one target, can change in one target.
Came through the shoot-off, of course, Suljana Gracz. So he's got staying power.
Oh. Oh. Looks like a miss, but there was a puff of smoke and counts as it.
Yeah, you can see Jan Rijber just calling the people with the flags either side in the little huts. Let's see what they saw.
And I think confirming with the side referees that they also saw the puff of smoke and that it's it.
The lady on our left-hand side, a little nod of the head. That was enough. And by the skin of his teeth, gets a hit. Yeah, through two shoot-offs, of course, the semi-final shoot-off as well. So it's been a long, long old day. He probably shot the most cartridges out of anybody, the Croatian, but the Russian here, who was second in qualification, hand goes up. What do you think might be the problem here?
I'm not sure. I think it's an issue with the timer or the timing. They started the timer and it starts flashing after when there's only each shooter's got 12 seconds from the previous shot. But in the case where they had consulting with, then they can only start the timer after the referee said ready or start. And I don't think it happened in that case. And he saw the timer flashing before him, and maybe it put him off a bit, and that's why he put up his hand.
Yeah. Just the smallest things from your normal routine. You don't want that to happen. Oh, the Croatian is hanging in there. Just that one mistake. Almost had another miss, but just about hit the target.
So after 12 targets...
12 targets then. Alipov still perfect at the moment. But the Croatian is not far behind and will still harbour some hope of that gold medal.
Final three targets of this gold medal match today.
As it stands now, it can all change in one shot, so let's see.
Yep, three to go. Unless it goes to a shoot-off, of course.
And keeps the pressure on with hitting that one very nicely.
Shooting first, of course.
Alipov replies with the hit as well.
Well, it's a high-class final, this one. Two Olympic gold medalists battling it out together. That was the difficult one away to the left, and he did very well there. 13-13, but Alipov with this one in hand. And well, Croatia now has to hit this one just to make sure, just to keep Alipov honest.
Yeah, just to keep the pressure on there. He misses this one, he gets the silver medal. So he would like to hit this last target.
And he does. So then 14 targets for Suljana Gracz and this one for gold for Alipov. And he does hit it. Brilliantly done. Another a seventh gold medal for the Russian. Alexei Alipov celebrates. Brilliant stuff. Perfect gold medal match for him. And the Croatian Giovanni Suljana Gracz He'll have to settle for silver. That's his first ever silver. In fact, he has that gold from Beijing. No other medals in the World Cup, so he adds to his collection as well in what was a very enjoyable final.
Yeah, and as I said before, the semi-final, it's a funny old thing, these semi-finals and medal matches. Experience counts for everything, and it showed today.
Eric, we thank you for your contribution. I hope you enjoyed your first World Cup. Safe trip back to South Africa. And that's how it has finished. Confirmation then of how it has finished. Bronze for Erminio Frasca of Italy. It's the silver for Giovanni Crnogorac of Croatia. And yet again, a gold for Alexey Alipov of Russia.
So, ladies and gentlemen, once more, please give it up firstly to your bronze medalist, representing Italy, Erminio Frasca. And your silver medalist, representing Croatia, Giovanni Kiovas. And your gold medalist, representing the Russian Federation, Alexey Alipov. Whoa, whoa. Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the men's event of this ISSF World Cup as quickly as possible. It will take place right here at the Shopman Range as quickly as possible. So please come and show your support for the final award ceremony of this Gabala World Cup. Thank you. The bronze medal representing Italy goes to Erminio Frasca. The silver medal representing Croatia goes to Giovanni Crnogorac. Gold medal representing the Russian Federation goes to Alexey Alipov. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of the Russian Federation. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we congratulate the winners of the Trap Men's event. So, ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the end of this year's Gabler World Cup, and it has been my pleasure to present to you these finals. So, ladies and gentlemen, we will see you at the next event. So, thank you for your support. See you soon. Bye-bye.